Good morning. Okay, I'm just trying to get the lighting set up here and get myself completely situated. So, let me just log in, make sure that we're on. Give you guys a minute to come pop on and join me. So, I'm watching That Thing You Do. Have you guys seen that movie? I love that movie. I'm the best girl, but I know one thing's for sure. Okay. Two seconds. I just want to share this really quick. Okay, maybe I'm trying to figure out how to do like a watch party. I was able to do it 1 week. It kind of just popped up for me and it's never done that again. Oh man, hold on. That thing, I know you're just doing that thing you do. I was telling Desiree that I watched That Thing You Do for one of my birthday parties. I think it was my 13th birthday party, so you know, it's a favorite. It brings back some of my youth. Okay, so jumping right in, today we're making a card using the Pattern Play stamp set. We're gonna use these heart images, this confetti, and then this little like beveled trim. We're gonna go ahead and do that. And Let me see. Okay, I'm going to kind of jump around a little bit while I share this project. So kind of bear with me. We're going to be all over the place. So let me get some things moved around so that I know what we're doing. Okay, so first I'm going to move this out of the way. Okay, this is a gray granite cardstock. We're gonna go ahead and fold that in half. This will be our card base using my bone folder. Do you guys like my silver nails? They match because of my silver promotion. Woo! I've got like a theme going on. Okay. This is my envelope. We're going to decorate the envelope today, so I have that. This is my inside. Okay, so I'm going to start with my envelope and my inside. I'm going to flip that over. It has a little something on it. Okay, I'm going to start. What am I going to start with? Okay, I'm going to start with Knight of Navy. So we're going to open this up. I'm taking the heart image with the solid image. I'm just gonna ink that up and I'm gonna put it right here on the left corner of the envelope. And then I'm gonna put one right here on the right corner of the inside of my card. And go ahead and clean this off. And we're done with this. So I'm gonna close this up and now I'm gonna open up the gray granite and I'm going to turn my envelope this way, leave this here, do that, and this time I'm using the outline of the hearts. So I'm gonna start with the flap of my envelope and I'm gonna line up these hearts like as close to the center as possible. And then I'm just gonna do them all the way across this entire flat, and it went off a little bit, but that's okay. I'm just gonna keep going the other side, and I think we could do like one more, maybe that works. Okay, so that's our envelope. So this will be the back flap and then the front, and then we'll go ahead and address and, you know, label like so. This is my inside, and I'm just gonna take the silhouette, and I'm just gonna do the same image just right on top, like so. Okay. Cut this or clean that. Okay, and then I have, this is a pattern paper from the, I think it's called Whale of a Time Suite. Or at least that's the stamp set. It's a little, a cute little whale suite. So you see the other side, all of our DSP comes, it's got print on two sides. We're gonna do this blue side. So I'm gonna flip this little strip. This is a little half inch strip cut at a half inch and 5 1/4. So I'm just gonna flip that over, and I'm gonna run some adhesive, maybe. No, I am. It's going to be a true story. I'm running adhesive right here, like so. And even though I'm getting better, I'm still not a professional at this adhesive. So, and I'm just going to line this up right on the left edge of the Whisper White. So it's going to go like that. Like that. And then I'm gonna take this beveled stamp, and I'm gonna go ahead and use the same gray granite ink with this beveled stamp, and I'm just gonna ink it up, and I'm gonna add this like beveled edge right here, just along this slip of paper that I have, just to give it just a little bit more detail. So, like that. Okay. And this is the inside of the card, so I'm gonna go ahead and flip this over. I'm gonna put adhesive on the back, and we'll stick that. You guys, let me know if that TV is too loud. We can turn it down. We're just enjoying our movie. Okay, so this is that gray granite that we folded in half. I'm just gonna open it up, and we're gonna put this centered right on the inside. Like, that's, there you go. Now we have a pretty fancy little inside. Okay, we're gonna set that aside, and now I have Whisper White. This is cut at 1/4 inch smaller than our card base, so when you fold a card in half, this measures at 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. So this is just 1/8 inch smaller, this Whisper White. This is that same DSP that we used on the inside. I'm gonna flip it over. And this is cut 1/8 inch smaller than the Whisper White, so it's 1/4 inch smaller than our card front, plus 1/2 inch on the width of it. So I'm going to line this up. I'm gonna leave just a little bit of white trim all around like this. And then you'll see this side has just like a thicker strip of white trim. So I'm just gonna take that beveled pattern again. I'm gonna ink it up in that granite gray or gray granite. And I'm gonna do the same thing that we did on the inside, and I'm just gonna stamp it across like so. Okay, so we have that. And we're going to, what do we do next? Okay. So I'm gonna put the ink away. We're all done inking for right now. And I'm going to take this. This is, what is this? This is polka dot tulle ribbon in Whisper White. So I'm just gonna lay it out over with some excess on either side. And then I'm gonna cut it off like that. I'm gonna grab myself two pieces of just regular scotch tape. I'm gonna line this up, try to line it up so that it goes straight across right here on the edge of that blue. Fold it over. This is like the cheater technique, so you're not having to worry about tying the ribbon or things holding in place. You kind of just tape it back there like that. Okay, and I'm gonna run adhesive here. And because I have that ribbon on it, I'm actually gonna be really generous with the adhesive and run it along the entire border of this. And then I'm gonna do some in the middle just to help hold this flat so that that ribbon, because it has texture behind it, we don't want it to pull too far off the card. Okay, and then I'm gonna put this down right on the card front, and it's only an eighth of an inch smaller, so it's gonna leave just a really small border of that gray granite. Like so. Okay, and then I'm gonna take just another strip of this tulle. Probably cut that way too long, but that's okay. And I'm just gonna slide it under this. And I'm not gonna do anything too fancy. I'm just gonna tie a knot. I want it to be closer to the bottom, not quite in the middle. And then because this tulle ribbon is like really, it's really dainty, I'm going to do just like a shoelace knot, or like just a regular knot. Okay. And then I'm going to trim it up so that it's like so. Let me grab, I want to grab a glue dot, because if this has a tendency to kind of pop up and then fold into itself. So I'm just going to grab a glue dot, use my tool. So I'm just going to pick that up, and I'm going to place this dot right under here. And that's just going to help that stay flat and stick there. Okay, then we're gonna set this aside really quick. We're done with that for now. This is just Scrap Whisper White. And what am I gonna use? I'm gonna use the gray granite ink pad again. And this Cue the Confetti sentiment. I'm just gonna ink it up. I'm gonna stamp it. I'm not worried about where it goes or if it's straight, because I'm gonna take this, I forget which one this is. This is a label punch. So I'm just gonna open it up, and then I like to use my punches upside down. I think that's how most of us use them. I just slide this right in, and then I'm just gonna try to center this up and get it as straight as I can before I punch it. And I do close my punch a little bit as I go, so it helps hold the paper, and I can still shift it just a tiny bit. And that'll go like so. Ta-da. Take a couple of these dimensionals. Take three of them. I'm just gonna like that. And okay. So now we've got dimensionals on there. I'm gonna line this up right just above that knot. Ta-da! Okay, and then last little detail. I'm gonna take these. These are just basic rhinestones. So I'm gonna take these, and I'm gonna put one here. So I think I've shared this before, but anytime you want to create like kind of like a splatter image, or like a detail that looks messy, I guess. The trick is to use an odd number of whatever it is that you're placing, because your mind will automatically place it in a way that's not symmetrical. So that's the trick, is to use odd numbers for your smattering of an intentional mess. Okay, so that's my project for today. So I'm using this card to celebrate my silver promotion, silver nails, little silver card. I actually have some silver confetti that I picked up at the dollar store, and I'm gonna put that in here so that when my people open their card, they'll get silver confetti, and it'll just, you know, whole little silver vibes. So here's the card. Thank you for watching. This is our matching envelope with some stamping on the flap and on the front, and that's it. I hope you guys have a wonderful Friday. Thank you for watching, and enjoy your weekend. Bye.